all. And he also said that the people that need to be thanked would be thanked afterwards at the reception, and that I shouldn't do that, but I'm going to do it anyway. In the particular case of Mark and being college, I've now played in this room many times with my friends. We've all played here at least once, so some of us more. And thanks to Mark and Matthew White and our Music Vancouver, and also Jose Stefan, who's the previous registered director for Music Vancouver. This wonderful collaborative project came to being, combining this music of Haydn that was commissioned by a Spanish priest in 1785, and this music of this poetry of two of Canada's most prominent poets that was commissioned in the fall of 2014. I don't know who had the more of the rush job, Haydn or Jen and Robert, but they've written beautiful poetry, which you will hear, which replaces what was the original text, which was the very ancient text from the Gospels that Christ is said to have said from the cross, and they've taken this inspiration and transformed it to a contemporary setting. So we hope you all enjoy that. We've had the privilege of going up to Quadra Anne, where Robert and Jan live, and rehearsing for 4 days in their beautiful library studio, first on our own and then with them. And then this is our fifth concert of seven concerts of the seven works in 7 days. So we hope you enjoy.
Forgive them, for they know not what they do. Although we've told them, showed them, laid the proofs out carefully and thoroughly, they know not what they do. They cannot know, cannot allow themselves such knowledge. No. Admitting they are murdering the planet is more than they can do. Am I my planet's keeper? The planet is a creature, too, a giant being dancing on its axis as it glides around the sun. A kind of mammoth coral reef of trees and grasses, dragonflies and chickadees, creating its own ocean of sweet air. And she can keep herself just fine, that dancing planet. She can keep herself just fine when no one pushes her too long, too hard, too far. But if you've damaged someone badly, are you not that person's keeper, nurse, or helper for a time? And when you meet a wounded creature, injured hiker on the trail, a crippled bird, a woman, or a planet raped and beaten, tossed like garbage on the shoulder of the road, are you not that creature's keeper for a while? Forgive us, whoever you are, because we never had a clue. Although they told us, showed us, laid the proofs out carefully and thoroughly, we never, never knew. How could anyone permit themselves that knowledge? To admit that we are doing what we do is more than anyone could bear. Thank you. This is it, the only paradise there is. I mean, it was the only paradise, the only one there ever was or will be, and the only hell, if hell is what you choose. Or if hell is all your parents and your teachers and your leaders in their wisdom chose to leave you, yes, or all you choose to leave. This is heaven. This is purgatory, too, although more sins have been committed than atoned for in this world. This is the one and only purgatory, paradise, and hell. And here we are in it. Here we are in it way over our heads, dead or alive, born or unborn. We are in it for keeps. We are in it to stay for as long as we give it. In it to stay for as long as we have.
Thank you.
Why? That final question, spoken in an old backcountry language, one the story still remembers, though the tellers have forgotten. Why? Because it was, it is, what happened. Why? Because. It is not God who's dropped the ball, gone AWOL, left the planet we depend on broken, pistol-whipped and tangled in the wire. It is not God. There are no humans without culture, and cultures, as they prosper, suffer many cancers. Money hunger, power hunger, righteousness, self-righteousness, delusions of eternal growth. You know the list. You know the endless lies we like to tell about not dying. Delusions of eternal growth are cancers, and a culture that is cancerous has turned against itself. It feeds upon itself. And cultures do not listen to their doctors. Social orders are invertebrates. All creatures who have brains live partially within larger creatures, swarms, hives, herds, flocks, companies, or countries who are brainless. That is who and what we are. So you can sometimes watch your species turn and walk away from everything that matters to a species. Life to live and air to breathe and time and space in which its children could be born. When you die, you go to heaven, we used to say. Is that what led us to believe that if we crucified the earth, heaven would erupt before our eyes? But when you die, you go to earth. You go to earth, and when the earth dies, heaven dies. It dies. Hell is the absence of heaven and earth. They will take it from you, yes. And they will take much more than everything you have. They will, we will, even you, as one more ordinary human, will take everything that anybody ever had. The air, the light, the darkness and its sparkle on the skin. The cool breeze that brings the hollow taste of water, the scent of fresh-cut wood and drying leather, and the savor of the apple and the pear. And you and I and they will take the leaves and petals, cresses, lichens, mosses, all the rivers and the river banks, the waterfalls, the streams, the beaches, rain, the ponds and meadows where the tree frogs sing their way out of this world and into another that is not yet born. And we will take that singing, too. And creatures tinier than dust, who have no arms or legs or hearts, will roll the stone against the door and spread their webs across the poisoned ground, dead oceans and the endless heaps of trash, and try again.
Thank you.